Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all for being here. Well, I sound like I'm in a closet or something. Anyway, I hope you can hear me a little bit better than you scream. I'll try to articulate as much as possible. This is always a special concert because this is the last concert of the semester for the CYO, and we have seniors that are graduating. They'll be moving on to bigger, better things, both in high school, but also in college as well. And I wanted to go ahead and recognize our seniors who've been a part, a really important part of the youth orchestra. I have no order, so I'm just going to I'm going to go ahead and start with our lone St. Mary's student, Nathan Day. Go ahead and stand up, Nathan. Nathan is a freshman Galana serving CYO participant. He's been with us for 6 years, pretty much before when Dr. Napa was here, right? So I inherited a really fine player, very enthusiastic, and really responsible. His parents are Melissa and Rebo Day. Are they here? Oh, welcome. Okay, let's see. You're graduating with a BA in Sacred Music. Bachelor of Arts in Sacred Music, and I love that. I actually asked them to write a sentence or so about how the favorite of their experiences. And this is lovely. It says, "I loved it. I enjoyed playing this music so much, and this ensemble has been an important part of my growth as a musician as well." That really means a lot to us. The next person is Riley Daniels, who's on us, who played the bassoon. His mother is Stacy Daniels. Is she here? Okay, well, she can see it online.
I guess.
She's in the back. Oh, hi. Riley goes to attend Benton High School. His band teacher there is Evan McCormick, who supplies a number of our women players here. Very, very grateful for that. He just joined basically this semester, I think I told him that I've been hearing about him for the last 2 years and cover team having a bassoon player in orchestra, and he's really, I couldn't believe that God smiled on me and he showed up one week, so really appreciate it, and glad. Let's see, musical honors. District top honor band, 3 years, all South top band, East top band, principal. He's applied to Louisiana Tech, and I think he's going there. He's majoring in biology and then going on to graduate school to become a chiropractor. I will be there after a conference. his statement is, "It's been it's been challenging yet fun, and has pushed me to become a better musician, and we can't thank you enough for being a part of the group." Next is Evan Bryant. His mother is Amy Bryant. He attends Benton High School, and he also studies under Evan McCormick and also Leroy Tatum. And he also, I've been coveting having more brass, and he also joined kind of late in the game, but really appreciate he's an outstanding player. He's a three-time All-State, four-time District 7 Honor Band recipient. He's applied to Northwestern State.
That's probably where you're going to, right?
Okay. And he's going to be doing a music edit performance double major. Good luck with that. And his CYO statement is, "While I have been part of many bands, I rarely get to play in an orchestra environment, and the CYO has been the perfect experience to do that." Indeed it has. Thank you so much for having me for being part of the next person that would be here is Parker Flume. He got sick, and so unfortunately, but I do want, he's watching online, and his mom is Kimberly Flume. He also attends Benton High School. He plays trumpet, and was singing second trumpet today. He's singing second trumpet today. He studies with Evan McCormick and Paul Tinker, and he also joined late in the game, but happy to have him. He's been in District Honor Band for 2 years, Mickey's Honor Band for 2 years, and his statement was, "This is the first it has been an amazingly new experience and has definitely matured and grown with me as a musician. So we appreciate you being a part of this park if you haven't been listening online. Ooh, this is getting hard for me to say. This is Emily Jordan. I was told about Emily before I got this job by Dr. Gabriel, and he said, oh, I think we might be getting a harp player. So I was like, oh, you're kidding. I mean, it's so weird to have not only a harp player, but a harp player that, of her caliber, who's she's solid with the orchestra and everything, and just going to really, really, really miss her. Her parents are Jason and Kelly Jordan. Caroline High School. I think she also plays in the band though, right? And her private teacher, actually she does online, FaceTime kind of thing. Her name is Alana Bonger. She lives in Loveland, Colorado. And she has been, like I said, she's been a part of us for the last 3 years, which is such a responsibility, but also such a privilege because she'd never played in an orchestra, and here she's playing She Hears, which is a standard piece, which is fantastic. She's applied to Colorado State, Louisiana Tech, University of Louisiana at Lafayette, and Centenary. And I think she is going to ULL in this fall. Her degree plan is art and creative writing, and she hopes to be playing with the orchestra down there at ULL as much as possible. Her statement is, CYO has been the biggest orchestra I've ever been in, and the longest one I've been in, one. And it's been super fun. I enjoyed playing all the challenging pieces we've worked on as a team, and I've really improved my skills, and you certainly have. Okay, I've got four more to go just in case you're keeping up. The next person is Taylor Moss. Her parents are Marn and Tracy Moss. She attends Parkway High School. Her private teacher is Miss Elizabeth O'Bannon. She's been playing in CYO for 2 years. Her musical honors include Principal Second in Centenary Youth Orchestra. She is the concertmaster of Parkway High School. I'm sure they really are going to miss her too. And she's been accepted and is attending Northwestern State University. I plan on majoring in music performance and see where that leads me.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it's probably going to lead you back here. Her statement is, I really enjoyed my CYO experience as a whole. For me, rehearsals and music has overall been an enriching experience. And you are such a wonderful person, just a wonderful, energetic person. You are going to really, really miss you in the session. So thank you for being part of it. Next is Catherine Phillips. Her parents are Carol and Joe Phillips. Are they here? All right. Go back. Okay, she attends Parkway High School. Her private teacher is Tom Hunderberg, and she's been in CYO 3 years. Her musical honors include 3-year LMEA All-State player, and she's been accepted to University of Louisiana Monroe. She plans on pursuing a music performance degree, and her CYO statement is, what I've learned from CYO is how to play in an orchestral setting while stepping outside of my comfort zone. Well, that's for sure. To play amazing works. And you've been fantastic. I know I've got you head for this concert, but over the years you've been really, really great. We really are going to miss you. Her father is Frank Messina. Frank Messina and Darlene Ainscope. She attends Catamount High School, where you're one of the concertmasters, right? Whole concertmaster. And she studies with Lord Crawford. disgusting. I think she's been with us for at least 2 years, for sure. She's been 4 years in Allstate, musical scholarship recipient, co-concertmaster, as I said, of Cattle Magnet High School. She also was a concerto soloist with the orchestra this past February. She's applied to Centenary. She's planning on double major in music and digital communications. And her statement, which is all red, I like it. CYO has such a nice, lighthearted atmosphere full of musicians of all ages, which we do, as you can see, and all backgrounds, just coming together to make great music. I truly cherish meeting and playing alongside these musicians, including our great and almighty conductor, Mr. Peter. The final person is, I'm going to consider her the recruiter of the year because basically she's the one that got most of these fellows that have come in the last minute. This is Autumn Tuttle. The parents are Heather and Rodney Tuttle. All right. Okay. And her, she attends Benton High School, and her private teacher who I work with in Little Rock is Dr. Lorraine Rizzo Kitts. She's been in the youth orchestra. I think this is her second year, actually. Yeah. And she's got top ratings in solo ensemble, first band, first chair in two all-region clinics, top band in honor bands, and she has applied to and is attending Mississippi State University. They're so lucky to have you. And her degree plan is aerospace engineering or pre-pharmacy. And her CYO statement is, I gained experience playing with instruments that I've never played with before, and we really appreciate you being a part of this for the last 2 years, Autumn. Please join us after the concert for a lovely reception honoring the graduates. I got a tape with actually all their names on it. So you might want to get the pictures before they start coming into it, unless they already started doing that. And so our final piece is their favorite thing ever, Pirates of the Caribbean. Gavin